Chef Ron's kitchen, and here he is, the man himself, Chef Ron. What do you got for us today?
Well, I don't know. I think I bought some chicken, and I have all this other stuff on hand, so I'm going to put it all together and make what I'm going to call a creative Italian chicken.
Wow. Buying zucchini, picking it out carefully at Pike's Place Market in Seattle. Those look like some mighty fine zucchini. And lemon. There's a lot to choose from here. Look at that. Morels, $40 a pound. We're not getting any of those. But Ron is going now for the onions. Wow, so what do we have here? We've got
tomatoes.
Pearl tomatoes.
Grape tomatoes.
Oh, grape tomatoes. Okay.
Lemon, zucchini, ground pepper, chicken, onion, garlic, pecorino cheese, freshly ground, olive oil, some of this seasoning here I picked up at Costco.
Well, wait a minute. What is it? Mojito lime?
Mojito lime.
Mmm, sounds pretty good.
What it tastes like. Little Italian seasoning, some Kalamata olives, and some...
Bernstein's, my favorite restaurant
recipe. Some
Italian
dressing.
Yeah, and what kind of cheese is that you grated yourself there?
It's pecorino.
Okay, we have some cloves of garlic there.
Garlic.
Okay, well,
onion.
Let's get started.
Let's get started.
Okay, what have we got cooking already on the stove, Ron?
Well, what I did, I mixed together chicken broth, maybe a cup and a half, some pepper, some 4 cloves of garlic, about a quarter cup of Italian seasoning, some quarter a cup of Italian dressing.
Yes.
And maybe a teaspoon of Italian seasoning. And maybe a couple of tablespoons of olive oil. And half of a lemon juice.
Half of a lemon, and that's all to taste, I guess. You can.
Yeah.
There's no written recipe on this. It's coming out of his head.
Yeah, it looks pretty good, huh?
It smells really good.
It tastes pretty good, too.
And what comes next?
Okay, what I've done here is slice the, I had Carol actually did it.
Yes, let's tell the truth.
She cut the tomatoes in half, and we sliced the onions, and we sliced the zucchini lengthwise.
What are you doing, Ron?
I'm making the chicken thinner.
Oh, I thought people usually pound the chicken to make it thinner.
Well, I'm not.
Well, that works.
There's another one. This one's kind of thick, so we'll cut this two times. Okay. Look at this.
Very nice.
Now, a little of the seasoning on it.
And that was what? That chipotle?
Just a mojito lime.
Mojito lime.
Mm-hmm.
Is it spicy?
I don't know.
I hope not.
You should probably taste it. No. And then we're going to put a light coat of flour on it so it keeps in the
juices. You didn't tell us about the wonder of flour.
Ah, yeah, just a little bit.
Just a little bit.
And then we're going to...
What are we going to do?
We're going to put it in the frying pan here.
Well, you got a couple of cloves of garlic.
A couple of cloves of garlic and some vegetable oil.
And that's where you're going to saute the chicken.
Just brown it. I'm just going to brown the chicken.
Okay. Okay, now we're putting a little olive oil in the two pans. And he's, of course, using his own hand to rub the oil into the pan. So it doesn't stick, is that correct?
Yes.
I'm learning. We're going to saute the chicken.
Brown it. We're going to brown the chicken.
Brown the chicken.
Just lightly brown.
Okay.
Okay, what we've done here is put the zucchini and some of the onions on the bottom, the thicker probably pieces on the bottom, and then we'll put the chicken and tomatoes on top and then some more zucchini and onion. And then we'll bake it all together. And then we'll put the broth on top, throw it in the oven for about 20 minutes to half hour till the chicken is fully cooked, and we'll be done.
There we go. Another healthy dish. We always are trying to incorporate more veggies into our meals. And this is a way to get some extra onions and zucchini and tomatoes. And with all this garlic, it smells really nice. Okay, Ron, you better tell the people that are watching this the little secret here that you're doing.
I'm just getting up all the stuff that was in the frying pan here. I'm just put a little lemon in there, a little bit more chicken broth, just to get it all together here, and I'll mix it in with the other sauce.
That makes for a very tasty sauce. All the little browned bits of the sauteed chicken.
And the garlic.
And the garlic. And the lemon.
Okay, and we'll just add this to the sauce here. Just a little extra flavor. And I can get my wife here to do up the dishes.
Of course, that's what I'm here for.
And we'll start to spoon the tomatoes on and the rest of this.
Yeah, how are you going to dress this up now?
Well, we're just going to have to wing it. Put the onion, tomatoes all over here. We'll put some in there, some in here. How's that looking, huh?
Wow, that looks really nice. It's so colorful.
And we'll throw a few olives in here.
Kalamata olives?
Kalamata olives. Just for effect here.
For a little tanginess.
A little tanginess. I think that'll make it real nice here.
Boy, this is beautiful. Ooh, and we have the sauce yet to put on it.
Mustn't forget the sauce.
And the cheese.
Maybe I need a bigger spoon.
Ooh, this looks good and smells better than you can imagine. And then the crowning glory is the cheese, the pecorino that you grated this morning.
Pecorino.
From a block of cheese, he grated this. So it's nice and fresh. Ready to pop in the oven? What temperature are we cooking this at?
I'm going to cook it at 400 for 20 to 30 minutes.
Okay.
And this is the finished product. Let's give it a try. We got a little brown rice here on the side and some chicken and zucchini and onions and tomatoes. Let's taste this. Not bad at all. Very good.
All right. Another successful dish by Chef Ron. Where's mine?
Yours is coming up.
Okay.